That's a dual boot. Alright. Yeah, I think I'm running Ubuntu 16.4 in there now, I think it is. But I swap hard drives because I don't want to corrupt this one in any way. It's a backup because I got the color on there for the Windows Media Edition. But yeah, and so this isn't why I love Dells, even though I do, because they are some really good equipment. They use good quality capacitors. Everything about their wiring harness, now that I got it stripped out of there, is click, snap, click, snap, everywhere you look, all of it. It's just awesome stuff. So what we are about to do is put in a 915G set, Intel chipset, this here Pentium 4 Prescott 3.6 that I just got from China in this here smaggled box. So 622. So if you want to upgrade boxes like this, do yourself a favor. Use the Windows Device Manager if that's what you're running. Find out your chipset. Then go to Intel or whoever made your chipset and verify what's compatible with that. Then verify what's compatible with the rest of the parts on your board and start from there. And then you can, you know what I mean? And I'm going to show you a bunch of machines like this. HPs, Dells, you know, I got them all over the place, including my laptop. And yeah. And that's a Dell 530, which is now massive. And I'm going to show you about that here in the future. But this, for me, tonight is about doing this here little swap. So first thing I got to do is go from A09 BIOS to 11. I believe it's A11. I got that on a drive over there on that other box right there. That's a Pentium 4 Extreme that I built up. And it's like, I don't know, 2004 equipment. Yet it smokes this Dell, which is the reason why we're doing this. The best way I found what the Dell software is, and you go to Dell.com for the machine you got, and hunt down their website for the BIOS that you need. If you're doing stuff like that, you need the newest one. Like if I'm getting, I got a machine here that's 2006, I gotta have something that's at least 2006 or better. Especially if the chip that I came out with is 2007 or 8 or something like that. And they were supposedly planning ahead. They knew when they were putting that chipset in there what its capabilities are. Even if they don't tell you, it's up to you to figure this out. This is how you can update machines that weren't intended to be updated. They want you to buy a new machine. However, I got machines that, you know, come pretty close to the newest of the new. And I just don't need any more power than that. So every time they sell me a new socket or a new little app to make it look like an Apple iPhone or something, I don't need that. I need to crunch my videos faster or something. You know, so first thing I need to do is find my BIOS file, which is on this here drive that I just plugged in. So we take this, and we copy that off of that drive, and put it here on the desktop. And that is, for this machine, D4700A10. I'm going to double-click that, and it's going to install that little file to my desktop. And I'm going to say, continue, because that's what it wants me to do. And go like this, that it comes out right. Yeah, hopefully my head ain't in there. Replace the A9 BIOS with the A10 BIOS. I don't know if you guys are reading this. Yes. Okay, this is the first step. You got to make sure that the, and supposedly for every BIOS, there's a little change log that they tell you what they did. And this particular one is update for newer CPUs. Attempting to update the BIOS. Please wait. Come on. Don't stall me now. Update successful. Awesome. And it's rebooting. Come on. Bring me right through. Okay, hit pause. BIOS revision, A10. Okay, you can see I got a Pentium 4 in there. Well, maybe I should go to the BIOS, the thing, and show you what CPU it is. F2. Okay, system info. Hopefully you can see this. Processor info. And it is a 2.8 gig CPU. It's not going to tell you the nut part number. And offhand, I don't remember what that is. But I want to say it's a 570, P4 570. Hyper-threaded. That's what I want to say. But it's 2.8 gigs. We're going to go to 3.6 gig chip on an 800 megahertz bus. If you read Tom's Hardware, some asshat says, oh, you got to have a P45. According to Intel, you don't. It's 800 megahertz bus chip. According to Intel, the 915G was built to run that chip, regardless of what anybody over there on Tom's Hardware tells you. Go by Intel, go by Dell, go by the chip. Make sure your numbers are right, and we'll make this work. Okay, I'll bring you back in a second. Okay, evidently I never did save CPU-Z over here. I was running it from another drive. But that's okay, because I'll just, hopefully you can see this, I'm just going to do this over here to my properties on my little computer, and I'm going to go hardware, then device manager, yeah, blah, blah, blah. We all done this a million times. If you didn't, well, I'll try it out. Where the hell is my computer? Where is my processor? Doesn't it say processor in here? Here we go. Processor, Intel Pentium 4 2.8 GHz. Here, let me zoom that in for you. that doing? Is that getting it? Is that good enough? 2.8. Okay. Yeah. Does this show me what chipset I'm running? I think it does in system. But we're not going to go that far because you are guys that already understand what I'm doing. I'm just showing you that it can be done. The heat sink's going to stay the same. Just the chip is going to change. We're going to take that 2.8 out. Yeah. So let's get the little plastic green things out. This is just stick your finger on the tap. Push that side out of there. Get this out of there. Yummy. Yep. And we'll be getting that off of there for certain. Yep. On these here, you can see it's a copper base as opposed to the aluminum on everything else. And there's a reason for that. And I really believe after using a Zalman CPNS 7700 on my P4, that it's likely that the CU version holds the total copper one. Once it gets hot, it doesn't release the heat as fast as the CUAL, which is the one that's half copper, half aluminum, which is why this is like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if you're seeing down in here. Tell you a little thing. Don't bend any tabs. Don't get any shank in the hole. Tell you a little thing. Eyeball where your arrow is. The arrow is to the bottom, right-hand corner. Yeah. Get that out of there. Hopefully. No problem on that 775. A nice little dust ball in there, too. Don't touch it with your hands. Get that out of there. We'll clean this up at another time. And, yeah, let me shine this up real quick with something so you can see it. Here, I'll use my hand. You really, there's no pins on the back of this, so other than scraping the resistance off the back, you're not going to hurt it. But, I don't know if you're going to see that there. 2.8. Doesn't give you another net. SL7PR. SL7PR. I don't know if that's a 527. I don't know if that's a number from Intel. I think it isn't. But yeah. Malaysia. So, yeah. And you can tell by the little pattern here on there how much of the heat sink was hitting and how much weren't. So we'll be able to fix that all up. For this purpose of the video, we're not going to bother. We're just going to show you guys that it can be done. So, yeah, my little chip right here. Hopefully you guys are seeing this all right. I'm probably standing in the light bulb for myself. And we'll change the paste out of there. Yeah, let me bring it back as soon as I clean the paste off the bottom of that thing. Okay, I got a paper towel here. And I'm not doing it over the machine. Because it's kind of dried up and crusty. And I'll give you another little hint about all the thermal compounds that are out there. This, I'm about to show you, is a giant package of DIM, heat sink compound. And where it comes from is my neighborhood plumbing man who installed the thermocouples into plumbing, into your oil burner at your house. And if you can commandeer some of these, this is what they put in the hole where they stick a thermocouple that tells your boiler to come on and off. And I was informed by him that there's actual amount of silver content in here, which unreal. Okay, great. And I've been running it on 3 different CPUs, and my temps are as good or better than everybody else's for everything else I do. So check it out. You know, I don't need that $15 Arctic silver blue, whatever. And I'm only gonna be just so careful with this. I only need a little bit. And the guys with the credit cards and spreading it out so it's a perfect thickness, that isn't necessary neither. Just not necessary. It's going to squeeze out no matter what you do. Simple as that. Put it over where it goes. Take my little paper towel and wipe off the plate like you watch on the cooking channel before you serve it. You know what I mean? Notice how the plate from the French restaurant costs about $150, but down the street it's only $20. You know? So, yeah. Plenty. More than enough. Way plenty. And it's not going to stick on there like that other thing. So, yeah. Here's my other little CPU here. And it is a... it's a SL... SLBQB, I think it says on there. Costa Rica. 662 machine. Chip. Yeah. Take that. Go like this. Stick the other one back in that slot. What I do with that so I don't smash it. Over here. Okay, good. Okay. Don't touch the chip. You can stand it. Especially with all the greasy fingers like I got right now. I'm making videos. This isn't something that I'm giving away. Okay. I'm selling for certain. Otherwise, the parts of this video you're not going to see is me taking care of the machine. I'm showing you how to do this. Okay, flip your thing. Then put this on here like this. Click. Okay, good. Take my heat sink with my new paste on there. Down in here, stick it in one side. And then with your fingers, pull out the little thing and hook it down. That's it. And then what I do, make sure she sprayed around good. Okay, give her a little tweak. Okay, good. Now I'll take my little plastic clippies. Okay, simple as this. Stick in here like this. One side goes one way, the other side goes the other way. Click. Oh, you hear that? Just the way Mr. Dell intended it. I love that stuff. Click, click, click. This is how they can sell these machines so cheap with such decent parts in them. Because they got it worked out. Their engineering department was pretty dang good. And one of the reasons why people buy Dells, besides the homeowners, is because they tested it to work. You're not going to have the crashes with the NVIDIA BIOS or the VIA chipset that nobody can confirm that it works. So there we go. Now we got that. What did that take me? 5 minutes? I know you've been wise and watching here, but go like this. Get this out of the way. Click. Okay, good. Here we go. Hit the F2. Go into the... Okay, so what does that say? Hopefully you guys are seeing this all right. I'm really kind of going quick here because making YouTube videos is hardly worth my time anymore, so this is for you guys, you know? Really. What the hell, it's down there. There we go. 3-6, there we go. Perfect. I didn't have to do nothing. Hopefully you guys are seeing that. 3-6. So from 2-8 or whatever that said, processes ID OF4A. There you go. Intel, and it's now a 64-bit chip. It will run. Hyper-threading, yes, 64-bit. And I do believe it's got, I think it's got virtualization on it also. Yeah, of course, the Dell BIOS doesn't have an option for that. But it must be on in there. I'm thinking it's on. Maybe it isn't. We don't know. So if I was to actually try to run a VM machine here, we'd find out whether it was actually enabled by the BIOS. And if you want to go deeper into these, they can be hacked and whacked and loading BIOSes that didn't come with it. There's a lot of things you can do if you do a little research. And a bit of it is checking the chipset and checking your bus speeds, making all sure that all those things line up right, and then buying a chip that's now RDRDR 10 years old and getting it for like $5. So, yeah. Properties. La-da-da-da. Yep. XP Certified 3, hardware, device manager. See that? Scroll down to processor. And there it is. 3.6. Okay? And it's showing two of them. Perfect. Hopefully you guys are seeing that already. You can see better than I can here. Hopefully. There we go. HyperThread CPU at 3.6. So, yeah. I mean, as far as upgrading Dells go, I think that particular upgrade from them in 2006 or 6, 5, 6, 7, somewhere when this Dell 4700, that was like an $800 upgrade to do. And honestly, I think you had to go to the 670 because the 662 with the virtualization wasn't available. So, there you go. I now have a 64-bit machine. I'm still running 32-bit software, but I can install 64-bit if I wanted to. So, hey, thanks for watching. John Rocket TV1 said that.